Welcome to the Sage Advice Podcast, transforming the way people think and work so their organizations can thrive. Well, hi, everyone, and welcome to our podcast. I'm Ed Kless, and with me today is Tommy Blinder. Tommy runs the funding team at Biz to Credit. He has 25 years of sales experience, including over 15 years in financial services for small businesses. Tommy has personally closed over $100 million in small business and commercial loans in his career, helping thousands of small business owners get access to credit. Before Biz to Credit, Tommy held sales leadership positions at Capital One, Chase, and Citi. As an area leader at Citi, he ran the top performing business banking division for the company nationwide. Welcome to the Sage Advice Podcast, Tommy Blinder.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
All right. First, tell me, why do you do what you do, Tommy?
Well, I mean, we're in the business of helping out small businesses every single day. It is important for us because that is the core of this country. You know, as long as they thrive, people have jobs, and, you know, the economy is doing really, really well. Most business owners, I admire them because they're investing most of their time into their business, and they could appreciate it very much on a personal level. And we like to help them. Finance aspect of it drives small businesses every single day. Cash flow is extremely important to them. And we're out here to help support that as they're out there purchasing additional inventory, expanding their place of business, opening new locations, hiring additional employees. You know, the capital is always needed, and we're there to help.
And what should CPAs be looking out for as signs that their small business customers need some financing?
Sure. Well, mostly it's about filing taxes at the end of the year. I mean, that's what CPAs pretty much complete. I've been dealing with CPAs throughout my entire career. I've had a lot of centers of influences that I worked with on banking world, and we're doing it here in finance company as well. CPAs typically have access to the entire financial situation of the business, especially when towards the end of the year or fiscal cycle, when they're putting all their numbers together, they're able to see whether whether the business owner is looking to expand, purchase additional inventory, if they're looking to open additional locations, if it's a franchise business, if they're looking to open up another franchise location, any type of equipment purchases or anything like that, you know, they're typically very vocal about it. So just asking those questions at the end of the year or at the end of the fiscal cycle when they're filing those documents for them, it's a really, really productive thing to do. And just simply prepare these folks for the future. Right? Letting them know exactly what the financials need to look like in order to qualify, what type of documents they need to have, the packages they need to put together in order to be prepared for that and such.
And how does a company like Biz to Credit work with accountants to apply for financing on behalf of their customers?
Well, that's a great question. So, you know, most folks out there, they like one-stop shop. You know, everybody likes when the institution they're dealing with takes a holistic approach for their entire situation. And, typically folks are familiar with traditional banking, and they're familiar with finance companies out there. They're familiar with insurance companies and other type finance services that are being offered. We are a one-stop shop. So here at Biz to Credit, we're able to structure deals. What we do is we take a client that is not qualified and we make them qualified. So we find ways to get things done. If it's as you can understand, you know, there are different bumps in the road for every single business out there. You know, they might be showing losses at the end of the year, and it's not because of their fault, but it's just because that year they purchased additional inventory or they invested more money in the business and they had to claim losses at the end of the year, or it's simply because it's a new business that they just started a year ago. So, financial companies typically, you know, especially banks, the old school banks, they typically don't see it as gray. You know, let me see if I could get them qualified. They see it as black and white. You're either qualified or not. If you showed losses, you're not qualified. If you showed profits, you're qualified. What we do at Biz to Credit is we look at other aspects of the business. So we will look at the industry. We will look at the footprint, where they come from. We'll look at the owner's experience in the industry, how long they've been doing this. We will look at the type of business they conduct and how their financials look like. We'll look at their personal financial situation as well, such as personal credit, and see how responsible they are in paying bills. So we'll find other ways to take a global perspective, so to speak, and qualify them. We could also take collateral, you know, if their own properties and such, we're able to take collateral and give them more money to support their business investments or whatever it is they're looking for. So for us, the most important thing is to qualify them. And we offer multiple products that we have here, including commercial real estate products as well, that helps us to structure those deals effectively.
And what are you doing right now during the COVID crisis to help with small businesses? And what's a little bit different from what's been going on in the past?
So we're very involved. We've been involved in a community, local community here in New York, and we've been involved all over the United States. We've been promoting our company. We are a certified SBA lender from paychecks protection standpoint. And we are out there helping those folks out get that paychecks protection program deals. So what we typically do is we're out there reaching out to these folks and we're collecting documents on their behalf. We submit those documents to SBA and we get them qualified. We reserve ETRAN numbers on their behalf and then we get the money out, sent out to them as soon as we can, as soon as the closing process is completed. So we're involved in educating. We have various webinars that we've performed with our partners, other companies we're doing business with, inclusive of folks that are coming into our website and they're looking for some advice. So we've done quite a few of those just to kind of be able to guide those business owners and point them in the right direction to make sure that they're, you know, have the sufficient paperwork that's needed for this specific program, to make sure that they're know what they need in order to qualify, to make sure that they know what they need in order to be forgiven, right? Because they will come for forgiveness afterwards. This program gives them that option. So we're educating them. That's our main model today, is to make sure we educate these folks and provide the capital along the way.
And Tommy, we have an exit question that we ask all of our guests, and that is, who is a hero of yours and why are they a hero?
Well, I prefer, you know, I like very strong character folks, and I, you know, I like folks that are pushing through thick and thin to make sure that they get things done. I also like folks that, you know, could appreciate the environment they're in and acknowledge what needs to be done in order to make that environment successful. So, you know, our current president, Donald Trump, is a huge inspiration for me. You know, I think his character has proven itself. Outside of, you know, his personal site, right? Just strictly business. I think that he's very efficient in what he does. And most importantly, he understands small businesses the way I do. And, you know, for me, that's the most important thing because, you know, I put my faith in our small business market. You know, I'm making sure and I do everything that's possible for them to succeed in order to promote our economy and do well every single day for the families out there. So yeah, he's been my inspiration.
And lastly, Tommy, how can somebody contact you?
Well, my phone, I have direct phone numbers here, which is 212-644-4555. And my extension is 143. So, you know, folks could reach out to me anytime. I have my business phone number as well, which is 646-944-5103. And those numbers are available. So I'm always on call. They could reach out to me. And my email address is tommy.blinder@biz2credit.com. It is probably the best way to contact me if they have any questions or anything. And I'm willing to work with anyone. So if any of the CPA need questions, if they need any proper guidance in terms of how to prepare their clients to obtain financing, you know, what type of financing they should be looking for, if they have a specific need, if they need anything that I could guide them, please give me a call and I'll be happy to chat.
And we also have an offer going right now that we'll put in the show notes page, which is to visit sagebusinessloans.com to apply through Biz to Credit. Tommy Blinder, thanks so much for being a guest on the Sage Advice Podcast.
My pleasure. Thank you.
For more Sage Advice, visit and subscribe at sageadvicepodcast.com.